you play to strengths, and Nard's the same. I think I've sprint finished, so I had to adapt my training so that I would do something in training. Maybe if I was doing something like 3x400, 64, 63 seconds, I would do a couple of laps in the middle that had to be quicker, because I was the same problem, that I had to do something in the middle of the race to either get away from the rest of the field, or actually try and take the sting out of people like Amy. But 9 times out of 10, come the last lap, it's still sitting on me, and you think, here we go, you know, so maybe can fly and pass. But for me, for 10,000 metre running, on the track is much different from the road. And the way I used to get through it was thinking, one more lap, I'll hang on for one more lap, for one more lap, and slowly, slowly, laps would come down. I would try to make sure that I didn't look at the lap markers. I would try and just get in a nice little rhythm, get my head down, and that was the plan. And because I've come from Norfolk and not having any big training, I've done all my training on my own, which I think sort of helped me mentally as well, and it sort of helped me when I moved up to the marathon, because, you know, you're running a lot on your own in the marathon, you're going to be on your own. So it didn't bother me the fact that the distance and having to run on your own for long periods of time, because I wasn't used to training with a group. So I think what you never had, you never miss, really. So, you know, basically I was happy to run on my own.